Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you. So as we know, we are discussing our second number lesson from the science, and that is what? Components of food. Okay, in the components of the food, we have already discussed some components, like we have discussed about carbohydrate, we have discussed protein, and we have discussed fat also. Okay, so now let's move for the next component of the food, that is nothing but what? Vitamins. Okay, so let's see why these vitamins are necessary, from where we are getting this vitamin, and what are the functions of the vitamins. Okay, so these vitamins are necessary for our body, okay, but in a very less quantity. But still, if the vitamins are necessary for our body in a less quantity, it provide or it perform a vital role in our diet. Okay, because vitamins helps our body to fight against different diseases, and that is the reason vitamins are called as protective food. Okay, vitamin is also called as protective food. Why it is called as protective food? Because it helps our body to fight against different diseases. Okay, so there are the different kinds of the vitamins. So which are the different kinds of the vitamins? Vitamins are different kinds, like vitamin A, vitamin B, C, D, E, and K. Okay, so these are the different types of the vitamins which are necessary for our body to maintain our proper health. Okay, and these different kinds of the vitamins we are getting from the particular food substances or from the different types of the food materials. Okay, so let's discuss from where we are getting these vitamins, or which are each and every vitamins are having their different functions. Okay, so let's see which vitamins we are getting from the which sources and which are the functions for that particular vitamins. Okay, so let's see the chart that here it is already given in your textbook. You can see on the board also, you can see in the image also, there is a chart, and in that different vitamins are given, their sources is also given, and their functions are also given. Okay, so let's discuss one by one. First we will discuss about the vitamin A. And what are the sources of the vitamin A? The sources of the vitamin A are green leafy vegetables are there, carrot is there, fish, liver oil. Okay, so all these are the functions, these are the sources of vitamin A, means from these all food material we are getting the vitamin A. Okay, now let's move for the what are the functions of vitamin A. So this vitamin A is necessary, or the function of the vitamin A is what? To maintain the healthy eyesight, and also to keep our skin healthy. Okay, so this vitamin A helps our body, or helps to maintain the clear eyesight. Okay, means it helps to maintain our good eyesight. Okay, in this way vitamin A helps our body, and also it helps to keep our skin healthy. Okay, so this is the function of vitamin A. Now let's see the next one, that is vitamin B. Okay, so the vitamin B is called as vitamin B complex. Why it is called as vitamin B complex? Because there are the certain vitamins, means from there are the group of the B vitamins. For example, we can say that vitamin B1, B2, B3 up till that B12. Okay, so like that, B1 to B12, this is the group of the vitamins, and togetherly it is called as what? Vitamin B complex, that is what? Group of vitamins. Okay, and which are the sources of the vitamin B? So let's see, we can say that green leafy vegetables are there, egg is there, meat is there, milk is there, whole grains are there, and also cereals and the nuts. Okay, so all these are the sources of vitamin B. From all this food material we are getting the vitamin B. So let's move for the next point, that is what? What are the functions of vitamin B? Okay, so it helps in the proper functioning of the digestive system, and also the heart, nerves, and the muscles. Okay, so this vitamin B complex helps for the proper functioning of our digestive system. Okay, and also it helps to maintain the heart, nerves, and our muscles. Okay, to keep our heart, our nerves, and the muscle healthy, the vitamin B complex plays a vital role. Okay, so vitamin B complex is necessary for the functioning of the proper digestion, or the proper functioning of the digestive system, also the heart and the nerves and our muscles. Okay, let's move for the next vitamin, that is vitamin C. Okay, so the vitamin C is also very important for our body. And from where we are getting this vitamin C, or what are the sources of the vitamin C? Let's see. Amla, citrus fruit, that is what, lemon and orange, we can say that. Tomato, guava, green leafy vegetables. Okay, so all these are the sources of vitamin A, vitamins C. Okay, all these are the sources of vitamin C. Once again, I will repeat. Amla, citrus fruits, like we can say the orange is there, lemon is there. Okay, all these are what, citrus fruits. Okay, also tomato, guava, and green vegetables. All these are the sources of vitamin C. Okay, let's see what is the function of vitamin C. It is necessary for keeping teeth and gums healthy. Okay, so as we know, vitamin C is very necessary to keep our teeth and the gums strong. Okay, if our body is having proper amount of the vitamin C, then we will never face any problem regarding our teeth and the gums. Okay, and also it helps the body to fight against different diseases. Okay, also the vitamin C is helps to fight against different diseases. See, now it is a time, okay, it is a very crucial time for all of us, because we all are facing from the one type of the virus, that is we are calling it as a corona virus. Okay, and to enhance our immunity system, we are or the media is telling us, or so many people are telling us, that our doctors are telling us, that you should improve your immunity system, you should take the vitamin C rich food in your diet, because this vitamin C helps our body to fight against different diseases. Okay, now the next one we can say that vitamin D. Okay, vitamin D. Let's see which are the sources of vitamin D. Milk, egg yolk, fish liver oil, butter, fish, all these are the sources of vitamin D. Okay, once again I will repeat. Milk, egg yolk, fish liver oil, and butter and fish, all these are the sources of vitamin D. And very interesting, very important thing, students, keep in your mind that this is the only vitamins that we can get from the external sources. Okay, for example, we can say that if we will sit in the early morning sunlight, then it is very helpful to our body to prepare the vitamin D. Okay, so vitamin D is also prepared in the body when the skin is exposed to the sunlight. Okay, so if we will expose, if we will go in the early sunlight, then now it is helpful to our body to produce the vitamin D. Okay, and what are the functions of the vitamin D? Let's see. Essential for normal growth of bones and teeth. Okay, so this vitamin D is essential for the normal growth of our bones and the teeth. Okay, so this is all about vitamins. Today we have discussed which vitamins we have discussed. We have discussed about vitamin A, vitamin B, vitamin C, and vitamin D. And among that, all that, only vitamin D is can get produced in our body. And remaining all that, we have to consume the different types of the food, and from that only we are getting these different types of the vitamins. Okay, so this is all about today. What we have discussed about today, here we have discussed that the vitamins are also called as protective food. There are the different kinds of the vitamins like A, B, C, D, E, and K. And also we have discussed about the their sources and the functions. Okay, so this is the time to tell you goodbye. I will see you in the next video for today. Thank you.